We gather this morning in the Holy Spirit Cathedral to welcome our new Nuncio to Ghana. St. John Paul II reminds us in Ecclesia the Eucharistia that, and I quote, every commitment to holiness, every activity aimed at carrying out the Church's mission, every work of pastoral planning must draw the strength it needs from the Eucharistic mystery and in turn be directed to it as its culmination, unquote. We are therefore happy to welcome you, our Nuncio, within the celebration of the Holy Eucharist. Your Excellency, the Church in Ghana is about 140 years old. In these 140 years, the Church has had a remarkable growth from being a small community of Catholics on the western coast of the country to the largest single Christian community with its members in all the 16 regions of the country. It is made up of 4 archdioceses, 15 dioceses, and 1 vicariate. There are 19 bishops and 1 apostolic administrator with about 2,000 diocesan and religious priests. The Ghanaian Church can also boast of about 60 male and female religious congregations. As a family, the Church in Ghana has a vibrant laity that supports its mission of evangelization. These are made up of various associations of men, women, and youth who have supported the Church over the years through their unique and numerous talents, and who offer themselves to be formed by the Church and be transformed also by the Church for a witness now and later in the Church. Some of our very dedicated men and women have been recognized by the Holy Father and have therefore conferred on them papal honors as knights and deans for the commitment which they show to the Church relentlessly. Dear people of God, our new Nuncio is the 9th Apostolic Nuncio to Ghana. He was appointed as Nuncio to Ghana on 3rd May 2020. But due to the challenges posed globally by COVID-19, he could only arrive in Ghana on the 8th of September, a Marian feast day. He commenced his official duty with a presentation of his letter of introduction to the Ghana Bishops' Conference at the National Catholic Secretariat on the 9th of September. Archbishop Jagodzinski replaces Archbishop Jean-Marie Spike, who was reassigned as Apostolic Nuncio to Slovenia and also a delegate to Kosovo. Our Nuncio was born on the 1st of January, So anytime you celebrate New Year, you think and pray for him on that day as well. He was born in Poland, ordained a priest on the 3rd of June 1995. He holds a doctorate degree in canon law from the Pontifical University of Holy Cross, Rome. In preparation for the diplomatic service, he studied at the Pontifical Ecclesiastical Academy. The Nuncio entered the diplomatic service of the Holy See on the 1st of July 2001 and has served in the following apostolic nunciatures: Belarusia, Croatia, India, Bosnia, Herzegovina, and Montenegro. He also served in the third section of the Vatican Secretariat of State, the section for relations with the state. Our nuncio speaks Polish, Croatian, English, French, Italian, Russian, and Spanish. So if you have been to any of these areas and you want to practice your languages with him, wait when he visits you officially. Dear Archbishop Jagosinski, as the Church in Ghana welcomes you today, we associate with the words addressed to Mary at the Annunciation: "Be not afraid." These same words are addressed to you as you put out into the deep. We assure you of our cooperation and total support. We do so trusting in Jesus' own promise, "I am with you always." This is our sure hope, and therefore you are not to be afraid. My dear people of God, the Church commemorates today a Spanish nun, Saint Teresa of Avila, of the Carmelite order, who was also doctor of the Church. Poised in her profound mysticism and prophetic in her own way, she was also master of the spiritual life. Saint Teresa of Avila took on reforms within the Carmelite order, and like Jesus, she was so courageous to speak out during the Reformation and the Counter-Reformation, which is the Council of Trent. We like to pray for ourselves that these Christian saints who have left behind a witness, irrespective of the challenges of our time, that she may intercede for all of us who have also set out on the path of sainthood. His advice and prayer to people of her time were, "Let nothing disturb you. Let nothing frighten you. All things are passing away. God, on the other hand, never changes. And if you are patient, it can help you to obtain all things. And whoever has God in his life, or makes God in the center of his life, lacks nothing, for God alone suffices." I'd like to say a few words about the readings we have just listened to. We begin the reading of the book of St. Paul's letter to the Ephesians. After we have listened to the problems which face the Church of Corinth and the Church of Galatia, all dealing with tensions and divisions of the Church. St. Paul, in the letter to the Ephesians today, advises us to see the Church as a mother and also a source of unity for whatever divisions and conflicts may exist in our community. It is this Church which has a mission to draw all things together under Christ. In the mystery of God's own design, we are entreated to avoid all that can make us deviate from God's plan of salvation for us. In the Gospel of today, Jesus, as usual, gets under the skin of the scribes and the Pharisees and challenges the life of hypocrisy, which tends to impose heavy things on their listeners, but will not lift a finger to seek what they themselves are recommending for their listeners. We need also, in our own days, to point out the hypocrisy that is sometimes with us and feel also called to reinstate justice and peace, especially now in this climate when Ghanaians are preparing themselves to go to the polls in the early part of December, and wish for ourselves that these our elections will come out peacefully. May God bless us all, and may we go back to reflect and contemplate the Word of God that is presented to us by the Church in all the occasions, daily mass, conferences to deepen and enrich us in our faith, and all programs of faith building and nourishing. I wish to thank all of you who have come here, some from far away, some from the different parishes here in Accra, so that as a united Church, we can give a hearty welcome to our Nuncio. I also like to thank the Nuncio for conferring on our Archbishop of Accra the pallium, the symbol of his metropolitan authority, and the symbol of deep unity with the Holy Father, who is ably represented today in this Eucharist by our Apostolic Nuncio.